I'm back with Heavy Rain. Hey guys, so third episode, this is where we have a new character. Welcome to the show.
Sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Norman Jaden, FBI.
Oh,
you got a badge or something, Mr. Jaden?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Check. You can pass.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Thanks.
Reporters. Already. You seem well informed. God, my hands are trembling. I gotta keep my act together. At least for now.
Video memo recording. Agent 47023, Norman Jaden. Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m. Unrelated to the investigation.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake. Thanks.
I've got to find Lieutenant Carter Blake.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake. Thanks.
The body must be under the tarp near the lights. There's a railroad track near where the body was left. Same as all the other.
Lieutenant Blake? I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning. They told me to be here.
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, will you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Right away, Lieutenant.
Well, are you coming, Dayton?
He seemed like a bitch.
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the origami killer.
Has the body been identified?
No, not yet. We should know more later today. Any news on the coroner?
He's on his way, Lieutenant.
We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
There are a lot of people on the crime scene. Aren't you afraid your men might destroy some clues?
You don't find proof sitting behind a desk. We're not in the habit of trampling things into the ground, even if we're not in the FBI.
No. No, of course not. That's not what I meant. Any witnesses?
None yet. Given the neighborhood, I'd be surprised if anybody saw anything. Tony, I don't want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Has the time of death been established?
Based on the rigor mortis, must be less than 6 hours ago. We should know more once the coroner has had a look.
The case seems to be attracting the attention of the media.
Yeah, a greedy pack of vultures. These guys have killed their mothers for a scoop. Some investigation. It's becoming a three-ring circus. Listen, I'm a little busy here. Why don't we discuss all this a little later, back at the office?
Oh, no problem. I understand. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jaden. You come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
Lousy weather, huh? Does it always rain like this?
It rains every fall. Doesn't it do that where you come from?
Well, yeah. Yeah, of course. When did they find the body?
Excuse me, but who are you exactly?
Norman Jaden, FBI.
If you want to ask questions, you should speak to Lieutenant Blake, sir.
Can you just find some clues? I'll just scan the footsteps here. Let me...
Harry, comment. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence. Superficial wound on the right thigh. Blood analysis suggests it could be post-mortem. Probably a scratch that occurred when the body was being moved. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion. A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death. The victim is Jeremy Bowles. Declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file. An orchid was placed on the victim's chest. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims. Harry, comment. Sample of no interest. Comes one of the policemen present on the wasteland. From the flower left on the bottom.
I'm gonna leave. I see you in the office, right?
Okay. See you later.
Strange character, that Blake. Didn't seem too pleased to see me. The killer must have carried the body here. Gotta be tracks around here somewhere. I could use a coffee. Might warm me up. The body got scratched when it was moved. There may be more traces of blood around here. Orchid pollen. Something the killer couldn't control. Can it be traced back to its source?
Butterfly.
Well, you don't.
A rat. A rat's head.
That's
a crab.
A crab. Death.
Death. Death.
Yeah, like psychiatrist or something. Oh, yeah, it's anxiety.
I have the results of your MRI scans. Everything seems to be normal. There is no physical damage from the accident. However, I am worried about your psychological condition. I know it's not easy, but you've got to start over, Ethan. You're not responsible for what happened.
It's my fault Jason is dead. He'd still be alive if I'd been looking out for him.
It was an accident. Accidents happen every day. You can't blame yourself forever for your son's death. How is Sean?
He's a very solitary kid, you know, very focused within himself. He's really close to his mother. With me, he's more distant.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
I no longer want to live. I have no reason to continue.
Not even for your son, Sean.
I couldn't save Jason. Sean doesn't need a father like me.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
What the? Blackouts?
I sometimes have these blackouts. Times when I don't know what I'm doing. I recover consciousness sometime later, but I'm someplace else. And I have no idea how I got there. Do you think this could be related to the accident?
You suffered a massive concussion and were in a coma for 6 months. We really don't know what effect a shock like that can have on the brain. That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week.
That lisp.
You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor.
What's this thing, like 0.986 inches or something?
How did things go at school today?
I was punished because I didn't do my homework.
I'm sorry about that, Sean.
Oh, yeah.
Next time, really pull it together, okay? Is something the matter, Sean?
No, I'm all right.
Aren't you gonna go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
Do you want to eat something?
We're just not communicating. Feels like we're drifting apart. Sean used to love going to the park, laughing and messing around. Man, he was so happy. But that was before, with Jason. What am I going to do to cheer him up? Maybe a ride on the merry-go-round. Sean looks so miserable. I wish I could help him. Just not sure I can right now.
Boomerang? You know how to use it?
No, not really. I can never make it come back.
Can I give it a try?
Did it, Dad.
Do you want to give it a try?
I won't be able to do it.
Oh, come on, let's try it together. Now, the main thing is to get the right position at the beginning. Now, you got to throw it straight and a little to the right. Now, throw it!
I did it, Dad!
Good job, Sean! See? That wasn't so hard.
Maybe you'd like to have a turn on the swings.
I haven't been on a seesaw in a long time. What do you think?
Yeah! Come on, Dad! Make me fly!
Thank you.
He seems to be having fun. It's been a long time since I've seen that smile. I'll find something else to do with him. Maybe he'd like to have a turn on the swings. Maybe a ride on the merry-go-round.
You want to go play on the swing? I'll push you.
Okay. That was cool.
He seems to be having fun. It's been a long time since I've seen that smile.
Looks like rain's coming. I think we better go.
Okay. You know, sometimes I remember before. I mean, when Jason was still here. Sometimes I wish everything could just be the way it was before.
Me too, Sean. Me too.
Come on, Dad, what are you doing?
I'm coming.
This is too quiet, something's gonna happen. It doesn't even seem too different.
Hey Dad, can I have a ride on the carousel? Can I?
Sure. Go pick a horse and get on. I'll get a ticket. One, please. That's a dollar.
I knew something was gonna be going on. Oh, it's a blackout. Shit. I wasn't ready for that. Go go back to the park.
Do you think it's gonna take long?
No, he should be finished soon.
He's trying on the glasses, boy.
I'm off, Charlene. I'll look at the reports later. Oh, cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain, Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps there's a better time.
No, it's fine. I just have to get to the press conference. We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell them. Fortunately, today we have some news. Have you met Lieutenant Blake yet?
Yeah, we met this morning.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get him well together. Do you know how to tie a knot in a necktie?
I guess.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press, they're all over us. This origami killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country, but what do you know? This guy is exotic. He leaves flowers and origami figures. Work that one out. Then the press get onto it, and we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
No, of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Not bad. Oh, go see Charlie and she'll show you to your office. Yeah, check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political climate around here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We've bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like. We're still a few dollars short.
Sorry, I don't have any change.
No problem. Maybe next time round.
Captain Perry said you could show me to my office?
Yes, of course. Follow me.
This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Okay, time to work.
Didn't mean to go.
Step one. Change the office.
Mm-hmm.
Well, well. Looks like there's something new. Harry, comment. Tire tracks on the side of the road behind the railroad line. It may be the killer's car. Eight victims in the last 3 years. All boys, aged between 9 and 13. No signs of violence. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything. Bodies are found 3 to 5 days later, drowned in rainwater. There is always a railroad line adjacent to where the bodies are found. And all the victims disappeared in the fall. The killer has a large comfort zone. He gained confidence rapidly and moved away from his base. This won't make the geoprofiling any easier.
Hi, welcome to the stream. I just analyze those footprints. Maybe. Geoanalyze.
No prints or specific clues. Nothing much to go on.
Origami. Next one. How about that?
The killer's car is probably a Chevrolet Malibu 83.
That's so useful, though. Okay. Type in chat who I was watching. Oh, is that? That flower. A flower of the orchid family.
Common species. That doesn't help much.
Clear all. Let's look at the map. Some of the files. Why did you just clear it?
Always the same ritual. An origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned. Over 3,500 people questioned. Over 100 suspects interrogated. Not a single lead to go on.
No, I didn't mean to... I think... Oh, what the fuck?
Here we go again. I better go wash my face.
What the fuck is happening?
I need to take some. I'm gonna faint if I resist. It's alright. I know I can make it. I know I can make it.
Exit.
Is everything all right, sir?
No one. No one will see.
I think he's on drugs. That's going to be the end of episode 3. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and peace out.